Hello guys and welcome to another wheel settings video on ACC. Now we've received an update today which has quite drastically changed the force feedback. It's now much stronger than it used to be when the game was first released on the PlayStation 5. I'm using the Fanatec CSL Elite wheelbase and these are my updated settings. I do have a previous video but they are now redundant essentially. The settings I'm using now are completely different. So we've got the gain on 65% here, the minimum force on 0%, dynamic damping on 100%, the road effects on 0%, then we've got the steer lock 640 degrees. That's set for the car I'm driving. You can actually just leave that on the maximum rotation for your wheel though, and the game will auto lock depending on which car you're driving, so you don't need to set it per car every time you drive a different car anymore like you used to on the PS4 version. Then we've got the steer scale on 100%, and the linearity, gamma and dead zones I've just left on the default. I'm quite happy with how my pedals are set up at the moment. I calibrated them on the PC. Now, one other thing that has been changed is you can now bind the shift up and shift down buttons if you wish to do so, but we're just going to leave those on R1 and L1. Then we've got our pit limiter on triangle, toggle wiper on R3, and next dash on R2. And then we've got increase and decrease traction controls up and down, decrease and increase ABS as left and right. We've got our flasher on circle, cycle camera on square, look back X, cycle MFD hub up and down on L3 and L2. And then all the other settings we haven't got anything assigned for. Thanks for watching guys, I hope this has been helpful for you. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, so you don't miss any more tips like this video.